Hi,
my name is Squad T8 and I'm Prato from Umen Primary School.
I'm from Squad 11, number 5, also from Umen Primary School.
Okay, for this lesson, it will still be
Techniques of Definite Integral, Chapter 2, Special Functions. So, right now, well, last few lessons we have done a lot of those questions, right?
Yes.
So what have we learned so far?
So we have the gamma function, the beta function.
Okay, the gamma and beta function.
Yes.
So we'll still be continuing with questions on those, okay?
Okay.
So let's see. Right now here we have question 1 and question 2.
Okay, so
we'll use one method for each of them, okay?
Yes, and next lesson we'll go on with method with the other method for question 2, okay?
Okay, maybe. So let's see. In this first question, we'll have integrate from 0 to infinity. X to the power of n minus 1 over 1 plus x dx.
So
for this question, first let me tell you, because we can't straight away change it into the beta function, so we'll need to use a substitution first. And I think you will like try this. I think this question is perfect for you.
I think I want the second question more harder.
Well, you can try both if you want. Okay, so let me just start for this first, okay?
Okay. So next will be mine.
So the first question, we can let. What would we let? Read it.
So we will let x over 1 plus x be y. Then after that, we'll let x equals y over 1 minus y.
How are you so sure it's a y over 1 minus y?
Not a y over 1 minus y, it's a y over 1 minus y.
How are you so sure about that? What? What are you saying?
We shift.
Like this then?
Then, wait, let me just say that first we will put this above, then we'll times it in, after that it become be in front, here which becomes x minus xy equals y, which means that I got the 1 minus y then. And shift that to the other side, okay?
So it's like this. And that's how you get it. Right?
Yes.
Then dx. What would we use now?
So now, dx, which, of course, there's the dy.
Obviously. But I don't know what is in front.
In front is the denominator is 1 plus y and the 1 minus y.
Is it just like this for the denominator?
Yeah. That's kidding, bracket square.
Now do you know what are we using?
And the numerator behind is the y. Quotient rule.
Yes, we're using the quotient rule. So we need to first differentiate with respect to this. So that will leave us with a 1 minus y.
Yeah,
then differentiate
was,
this. Because there's already a negative, so it becomes a positive. Then here's the y. So then here is the dy, okay?
Okay.
So we don't need all of these. So right now, what else is missing?
What?
We still can put in one thing here, right? So can you tell me what is that?
So we miss out the range.
For?
Wine.
Now what is the range for wine? What is it?
So the range for y is from 0 to 1.
Yes, it is from 0 to 1. But can you tell me why?
And we have it in.
So can I write it out? What is it actually like? Well, actually, don't need to write, you can just say it.
So here, actually, why is wing? So here.
Faster.
So here we just sub it in. So if x was a 0, y would also be a 0. But if x was an infinity,
but y would
be a 1.
Okay. So yes, correct. You sub those in, right?
The y just now is a head.
Okay, because here when you sub in 0, 0, 0, right? I was about to ask you, what if it is infinity? Why is it a 1?
Okay.
Why?
It's a 1 because that is the infinity over infinity, which is the indefinite integral.
Indefinite integral? Indeterminable form.
Oh, I meant by indeterminable form.
So you need to use the L'Hopital's formula, right?
But don't pronounce L'Hopital as hospital or hospital.
Is there a L'Hopital formula? Isn't it the L'Hopital's rule?
Wait, but I just need a reminder for I don't pronounce the L'Hopital's rule wrongly.
So, for this, that is how you get this range for y, right?
Yes, sir.
Now can we start?
Yes, sir.
So this is from, at first, when it is still an x, it is from 0. All the way to infinity.
Yeah, Dad.
So, right now, this x to the power, we're still copy this down.
Okie dokie, okie.
So it's like this. Then next, you'll start solving them in.
Not right? Solving them in, it's
subbing them in.
Thanks.
So, x, what do we sub it for? What do we sub it for?
Dust.
You mean this?
Yeah, that's what I'm pointing. Thus.
Then, this, do we need to put it in?
Okay.
This fraction, when you change the x into a dy?
Okay. Okie dokie. Let me just ask you something. Yeah, can you just minus away? Because minus.
I'll just copy it down first.
Fine, if you want to.
So, for this. Well. Now what? I'm stuck here.
You're not stuck. You could common denominator.
Where? Which part common denominator? These two?
Yeah.
These two?
No. In the middle.
So you say these two?
Yeah. Just now, I was just kidding.
So for this. Why is it still an N?
Is it an N? I thought it's an N minus 2. Whoa. I know why. First, let me just start this step by step. Okay?
Okay, so you can come here to explain about this?
At the first place here, we need to simplify these two, which make it a minus two. Then after that, here perfectly got a two. So recap.
Wait. This is a one. We only have one of them.
Yeah.
So we simplify one. Then we times back two of them.
Yeah.
So is that what you mean?
Yeah.
But how about these? This part when after the common denominator, the numerator, what happened?
One.
Why?
Because one minus y plus y, which make the minus y and plus y simplify. After you make the minus y plus y simplify, and that's it. One.
So next, I'll just write it in powers.
Why do we write it in powers?
So that it can be clearer. Then next, we can change it into the beta function, right?
Yeah.
So now what?
Gamma, beta. Beta, gamma. Beta, yes. After that is a gamma. We convert it to a gamma, yeah.
Oopsie.
Then.
So now for this, at the denominator is a gamma 1, right?
Yes.
So that means it is a 1, right?
Yes.
Now here comes a problem.
Why the problem? Gamma.
Oopsie.
Gamma.
So we have this part, right?
Yes.
Then now, it seems like that we're stuck. Can you save away?
Is it Euler's?
Euler's? What's got to do with Euler's over here? It's the Euler's reflection formula.
Euler's refraction of lead.
Formula.
That's giving. I will write that for you.
Gamma or Mula.
Like this?
Yep. Now what is that formula?
It gotta do something with gamma.
Are you sure gamma z?
Well, here I haven't write finished. You fill in the gap. I don't know what's inside.
Okay, let me write this. Now, this is not a plus. It's a minus. Here's a 1 minus.
Yay.
Then you have a pi over sine pi
back.
Z.
Let me just put something back with Z. Yeah.
So it becomes like this, right?
Yep.
So now we can apply that formula, right?
Yep.
That means now we'll have pi over sine and pi. Right? So this is the answer.
Yes, sir.
Now it's your turn for the second question.
What I mean by oil means Euler's refraction formula for the next question also need.
Well, we'll see about that. So this is the first question.
Okay, you say no, I say yes, okay?
So far so good?
Yeah.
Okay, so right now we'll move on to the second question. Okay, next, the second question. You will solve this.
But you missed out something. You know why you're something?
So let me read this question.
Yes, that's just something.
So this question is integral from 0 all the way to 3.
Whoa.
Then it is x times cubic root 27 minus x cubed, then dx.
So let me ask you, what should we let?
So the thing that we should let is,
should we let x be
now you're writing it out. You're getting it right.
I just put that in just now. Okay.
Okay. Then you can dx equals whatever stuff. So right now, you're differentiating it, right? Right?
Yes. AKA simplified. Right?
What thing is it?
Means that AKA dy over...
What thing is also known as?
Just now I wrote with it 3 over 3. Yes, what's missing?
Okay, so let me just tell you, there's actually another spelling error here. You don't have an R here.
You know, it becomes formula A.
Continue.
Okay. What are we left with? Wondering.
The boundary for y?
What is it?
0 to 1.
How did you know? Creepy. Actually, you're so creepy.
And your ending bracket.
You know what I just want to do just now? Like those.
Quickly. You need to sub it in.
Yes.
And why is this just equals? Are they below, please?
Be below. What did you say?
Quick. So, X, sub this thing.
Ha, 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 ha.
What's wrong?
Ha, 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 ha.
Okay, so straight away tape. A three from here and a three from here.
Ow, you got my trick. The 16 to the trick. And what is it?
Okay, so
you're sitting on it or what?
I'm just trying to watch you.
Fine.
So at this part, okay, you still have that cubic roots. Okay, so inside there become a 1 minus y, yeah. And then what is the dy?
Still have something fishy you didn't love. Ha! Ha! You know what?
What is your 1 over cubic root y?
Do you think should there be a square?
Oh yeah, there should be a square.
Ha! This part, I guess now miswrite the square line?
Yeah. Quick.
Focus, focus, everybody focus.
Quickly.
What are you doing?
I'm watching you.
Nay, I'm not gonna do that.
And also write it in powers.
Yes, that's what I want to do.
Okay, continue. Quick.
I haven't finished.
And where's your water? Okay.
Then if I don't have a water, why is that bracket for? Why didn't I write the instructions? Guess why? Guess why? Why didn't I write it?
I've already said it a lot of times. We want to write it in power.
Okay.
Quick.
Like this?
And why is it still 2 over 3? Shouldn't it divide? When you divide, it's still 2 over 3. Isn't it a negative 1 over 3? Simplify.
No.
I also write your negative bigger. Why is it a 2?
Like this?
Yeah. And don't forget about your dy. What's wrong here? Okay, that's more like it. You sure about that? Yeah.
Now. Just ding, 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 ding.
Now, from beta function, now change it into
gamma
function, I mean.
Can you fill in the gaps? Fill in the gaps. Not that. Okay. Yes.
Done.
Very good job. You goodie.
Wait, even though you're not a goodie.
This, what would you need?
Why did I erase the 9? Guess what?
I don't get it. Why?
Then guess why I do the. Then.
Why is it now 12?
Yes. A 3.
Now what happened there?
Don't you even know? But something crazy happened, I think.
Okay, so basically you took out 1/3, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that is right. So now, you need to change this into a 1 - 1/3. Change it!
Okay.
Quick. Faster.
Bucky.
Quick.
Nearly finished.
So now you need to use the Euler's reflection formula.
Nah. I don't want to use. What I mean is.
Guess so what? Below there is a sine pi over 3, right?
Yes.
Okay, it's square root 3/2. That means you changed it. And I knew it. Now you can simplify it. Simplify. You can simplify a square root 3. Why don't you want to simplify?
Later.
You can actually simplify it from here. But never mind. Okay, so that is the answer that you should get.
Actually, what?
Okay, so in this lesson, are you clear?
This lesson, it's okay that if you don't write this, but it's better off writing this, but if you don't write this, also okay.
So are you clear so far?
Of course I'm clear. You're clear, right?
Yep. So, is there any more other things or questions that you would want to say or ask?
Nothing about those, but something about others.
So, if you like our videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
Okay, so see you in the next next video.
Okay. Thank you for your watching.